Morning students, now we go for another chapter, an easy chapter which is called placement models, a simple chapter. You can expect one question of 10 marks. During May 18 they have asked one question, replacement models. You can think of replacement means something worn out by tear and tear need replacement. Anything, any equipment, maybe bulb or machinery or anything, requires due to wear and tear needs a replacement. Therefore we have replacement model. There are several types of replacement models. Out of that, one is normally asked, being asked. Then replacement model means if any equipment or item he used for a longer period of time, it tends to worsen due to wear and tear. A remedial action is to bring the equipment to the original level as desired, so that production or any activity based on that will not suffer later. The need of replacement becomes necessary under this condition. This need may be caused by normally a loss of efficiency, failure or breakdown of the item or equipment. The problem of replacement is to determine the appropriate time at which a remedial action should be taken, which minimizes some measure of effectiveness. Effectiveness. Therefore, replacement means due to efficiency loss, due to wear and tear of any item or equipment. This comes under replacement model. Type 1, simple type, normally being asked. And the model, it is called replacement models that deteriorate with time. Deteriorate with time, whose maintenance cost increases with time. For example, type 1, normally being asked, type 1, you can note down a question. Then, question is, the cost of an equipment is 10,000 rupees. The annual operation and maintenance cost, maintenance cost and its resale value are given below. Then determine at what time it could be replaced. Underline, it could be replaced. It could be replaced. This is a normal type of question coming through. And the datas are, you can write end year. That is the first column. Then you can write operation and maintenance cost. Operation and maintenance cost. maintenance cost given in the question. Maintenance cost, then resale value. These three detail will be given at the end of year operation, or we say O and M. Resale value, you can write 1 to 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Annual operating and maintenance cost equal to 1000, first year 1000, 1200, 1400, 17, 2000, 25, 3000, 25, 3000, 3500, 3500. Then resale value. Third item given, 1000, 1200, 1417, 2025, 3035. Then resale value 1000, 22. You have 3, 6, 5, 3, 7, 3, 5, 3, 7, 3, 9, 8, 128, and 16, 300. Resale value. Sorry. Cost of, okay. Maintenance cost, okay. Resale value. 1200, 1400, resale value slightly different, sorry. Resale value given in the question, resale value 6000, 4000, 2625. 2625, 24, 2000, 1600. Resale value is 6000, 40, 32, 26, 25, 24, 20, 16. Operation 1000, 1200, 14, 17, 20, 25, 30, 35. Determine at what time it should be replaced. First step, find the cumulative running cost. First step, you can note down, find the cumulative running cost or cumulative of the second column given. Of the second column given. Cumulative of second column or second column is O and M. Cumulative of second column. Operation and maintenance column. Therefore, you can write 1000, 22, then 36, 53, 73, 98, 128, 160, 300. It is total of this 16,300. Therefore, 16,300 total. Pre-sale value given, third column given. Then, second step, construct construct fourth column, third, fourth, fifth column, construct fifth column as, fifth column as, construct the fifth column as, fifth column as, value of the equipment, value of the equipment minus resale value, resale value, which is called capital cost. Capital cost. Fifth column is second, third, fourth column is total of second column, cumulative total of second column 16,300. Fifth column is value of the value minus resale value, or we say capital cost equal to value of the equipment is 10,000 minus resale value is this 6,000. You have 4,000. 10,000 minus 6,000 resale value, capital cost equal to 4,000. Second one, capital cost will be 10,000 minus 4,000. 10,000 minus 4,000 equal to 6,000. Similarly, third value will be 10,000 minus 3,200. 10,000 minus 3,200 equal to 6,800. Then fourth will be 7,400. Similarly, 10,000 minus 2,674. Next value will be 75, 76, 8,000 and 8,400. That is 10,000 minus 1,600 equal to 8,400. That is your fifth column. Fifth column. Then next column will be, next column will be column number 4 and 5. Column number 4 and 5 are equal to cumulative cost, or cumulative O and M plus resale value. Cumulative O and M plus capital cost, fifth column. Cumulative second column, cumulative fourth column plus capital cost. Cumulative fourth column 1,000 plus 4000 plus 4, you have 5. Then similarly, cumulative 2 plus 6000, 2 plus 6000 equal to 8200. 8200. Next will be 10400. Then 12,700. Then 14,800. Sorry, 14,700. What is that? Cumulative value 73 plus 75. 14,800. Then you have 17,400. Then 2,800. And the last one, 24,700. Last one, 24,700. Therefore, total last column, that is fourth column plus fourth column plus fifth column, or cumulative OM plus capital cost. Next column, you have average annual cost. Average annual cost. Therefore, step number one was find the cumulative operation and maintenance cost, cumulative of second column, given second column. And the fifth column was capital cost, named as capital cost, equal to value of the equipment minus resale value. Value of the equipment minus resale value. And the next column was cumulative of second column plus capital cost, which gave you this. And the last column to be calculated, you can write 5000 by first year equal to 5000. Then 8200 by the second year equal to 41. Then 10,400 by third year, 34,66,70, and 12,700 by fourth year, 31,75, and 14,800 by fifth year. Fifth year equal to 2940, and 17,400 divided by sixth year, 29. Then next will be 297140. 297140 and 3089.7. Now you can note the point 2940, then 2900, 2971, 3089. And you can specify this 2900. Specify that 2900. 2900. Now you can wrote that here at the end of 6th year, at the end of 6th year, the average annual cost equal to 2900. Average annual cost becomes 2900 equal to minimum cost, and prior to that and succeeding to that are higher than 2900. Earlier is 2940 and after that 2971. Therefore, we conclude 2900 minimum value corresponds to end of sixth year. That is, we conclude that the equipment should be replaced at the end of 6th year. So you find the average and find the minimum, and you can see that the minimum value corresponds to 6th year, at the end of 6th year. Therefore, the item should be, or the machinery should be, replaced at the end of 6th year. Then another one, same way, you can write an auto rickshaw driver finds from his records that the cost per year of running his auto rickshaw, whose purchase price is 7,000 rupees, as given below. You can write year 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then you can write here second column running cost. Then resale value. Resale value. And here you can write second column, you can write running cost 1100, 1300, 1500, 1900, 24, 29, 35, 41, 11, 13, 15, 19, 24, 29, 35, 41, and resale value 31, 16, 100, 850, 475, 300, again 300, again 300, 300, 300, 300. Then write at what age the replacement is due. The replacement is due. Replacement is due. Now you can create step number one. Create column another 1, 2, 3, 4. Create another 4 columns. Create another 4 columns apart the given columns. Apart the given columns. Step number two. Find the cumulative of second column or cumulative of running cost. Cumulative of running cost. Initially 1100. 1100. Then 24. That is 1100 plus 1300. 24 plus 1500. 3900. Then 5800. Then 8200 and 11100, 14,600 and 18,700. Which tallies with second column total? 18,700. Which tallies with second column given total? Given total, it's 18,700. Then next column, capital cost equal to value of the auto rickshaw minus resale value. Value of the auto rickshaw is 7000 minus 3100 resale value equal to 3900. Then 7000 minus 1600 equal to 5400. Then 6150. Then you have 6525. You can see 7000 minus 475. 6525, 67, again 67, 67, 67. Then next column, cumulative running cost plus capital cost equal to 5000. 3900 plus 1100, 5000. Then 7800. 10,500. 12,325. 14,900. Then 17,800. 2100. 25,400. The last column is cumulative running cost plus capital cost obtained. That is 4 plus 5. Okay. Then last column, average annual cost, right? 5,000 by first year, 7,800 by second year, 10,500 by third year, 3,380, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 3,080, 75. You can mark specifically sixth year and straight 29, 66, 70. Therefore, here we observe, you can write, here we observe the average annual cost of the auto rickshaw at the end of sixth year is minimum and equal to 29, 66, 70, and the average cost above that and below that are higher. Therefore we conclude the equipment should be replaced at the end of 6th year, being the lowest average annual cost, being the lowest average at the end of 6th year. Please note, at the end of 6th year, that is from 6th year it increases. Another type is replacement of items that fail suddenly, bracket, preventive replacement is opted. Then you can write explanation. We have considered under type 1 replacement of items that deteriorate with time. Here we have a situation where the item do not deteriorate with time but fail suddenly. For example, electric bulbs, radio or tubes, etc. The sudden failure of an equipment may cause a complete breakdown of the system. So we have to know in advance as to when the failure is to take place, so that the equipment can be replaced before it actually fails. Here we have preventive replacement. Preventive replacement is a procedure which provides for placement after a time when the effect of aging has become sufficiently critical. Even if the actual failure has not yet occurred, this replacement will reduce the number of sudden failures or breakdowns. Sudden failures or breakdowns, and is quite economical. Normally, it is difficult to predict that a particular item will fail at a particular time. In such cases, the time of failure can be predicted from probability distribution of failure time given by certain mortality tables. Here we have two types of failures. One, individual replacement policy. Under this policy, the item is replaced immediate replacement. Then type 2, group replacement policy. Under this policy, all item must be replaced irrespective of whether they have failed or not, with a provision that if any item fails before the optimal time, it may be individually replaced. Here we do a problem under individual replacement policy. Normally they can ask you that with a given probability, individual replacement policy. Here the probability of failure will be given, which is obtained from mortality table. Slightly different procedure, but it is easy. You can write, find the cost period of individual replacement policy of an installation of 300 bulbs, light bulbs. Given the following details. One, cost of replacement, 2 rupees per bulb. 2 rupees per bulb individually. Then, second, conditional probability of failure is given. conditional probability is given. You can write end of week, at the end of a week, end of a week, first column. Second column, conditional probability. Conditional probability. Conditional probability. 300 bulbs, cost is 2. Here, you can write here, individual replacement policy. Individual replacement policy and the cost involved. Here, week, first week, second week, third week, fourth week. This is at the end of, that is installation time. 0 means installation. At the end of first week, second week, third week, fourth week. Conditional probability given. 0 probability, 0.1, 0.3, 0.7, 1. 1. That is initial step 0. At the end of 1 week, the probability of failure, individual failure, can be 0.1. At the end of second week, it can be 0.3, 0.7 and 1. First step. Here we calculate the following. We write P naught equal to probability at the beginning, at the time of initial installation, probability of failure 0. Then P1 at the end of first week 0.1. Then P2 probability end of installation 0, at the end of first week 0.1, at the end of second week equal to 0.3 minus 0.1. Here this has already occurred. At the end of second week, probability of total failure is 0.3 minus 0.1 equal to 0.2. Similarly, P3 equal to 0.7 minus 0.3 equal to 0.4, and P4 equal to 1 minus 0.7 equal to 0.3 equal to 0.3. You can see 0.1 plus 0.2 plus 0.4 plus 0.3 equal to 1. P1, 0.2, 0.4, 0.3. Therefore, further P4, no more probability given. Therefore, you can note all probabilities higher than P4 are 0. All probabilities higher than P4 are 0. Since total of the probability is always unity, 0.1, 0.2, 0.4, 0.3 equal to unity. Therefore, you can write next step. Mean life of bulbs equal to first week 1 into 0.1, then second week into 0.2 plus third week into 0.4 plus fourth week into 0.3. Here it is 0 into 0 gone, 0.1 into 1, 0.2 into 2, 0.4 into 3 and 0.3 into 4. Equal to 2.9 weeks. 2.9 weeks. Therefore, you can write the average number of replacement will be average number of replacements will be 300 by 2.9. 300 is the bulbs given by average, by mean 2.9 equal to, it comes down to approximately 103 bulbs. Therefore, you can write here the average number of replacement will be if it is under individual replacement policy, will be 103 bulbs. It will be equal to 103 bulbs. And therefore, the cost of individual replacement will be equal to 103 into 2 rupees given. 103 into 2 rupees given, that is 206 rupees. Individual replacement will be 103 into 2 rupees given. That is about replacement theory or replacement method, a simple method. You can expect one question for 10 marks. You can expect one question under this. They may ask you, so simple, therefore you can. And you can specify and specify here a small note. Here in all these questions we have ignored changes in the value of money during these periods of observation. Changes in value of money during the periods of change. Then, next one, they may ask you, define what is meant by, what is meant by a decision tree? Or explain decision tree. We'll be doing one question under this as an example, and I'll give you separately a note on decision tree. Separate note I'll be giving you separately, but initially I'll give you what is meant by decision trees. A decision tree analysis, involves the construction of, a diagram that shows at a glance, which decision are expected, to be made in what sequence, their possible outcomes,
possible outcomes. Possible outcomes.
Possible outcomes.
Possible outcomes. Then a decision tree consists of nodes, NODES, comma, branches, probability estimates, and payoffs, PAYOFFS. Decision tree is the graphical representation or display of the progression of decision and random events. The decision tree, as said earlier, consists of nodes and branches, and the nodes are NODES. Nodes are two types: decision node, chance node. Course of action or strategies originate from the decision nodes as the main branches. Now you can draw this one. This is the beginning. A1, A2, A3 are strategies. A1, A2, A3 are strategies or course of action, or we say act. A1, A2, A3 are called strategies or acts. Then E1, E2, E3 are events. E1, E2 are events, and O11, O12, O21, O22, O31, O32 are called outcomes. The decision tree analysis allows one to understand
simply by inspection, comma, various assumptions and alternatives in a graphical form, which is much more easier to understand than the abstract analytical form. Now you can draw this decision tree. Starting point A1, A2, A3 are acts or strategies. Then these are E1, 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 E2, etc. are called events, and O11, O, etc., etc. are called outcomes. Then I'll give you one example. For decision tree. You can analyze this and easily you can conclude. You can write the question. There is 40% chance that a patient admitted to the hospital is suffering from cancer. A doctor has to decide patient. Doctor has to decide whether a serious operation should be performed. If the patient is suffering from cancer and the serious operation is performed, the chance that he will recover is 70%. Otherwise, it is 35%. On the other hand, if the patient is not suffering from cancer and the serious operation is performed, the chance that he will recover is 20%. Otherwise, it is 100%. Assume that recovering and death are only possible results. Construct an appropriate decision tree and what decision should be taken by the doctor. Here, we are analyzing the chances of doing the operation or without doing operation, and what is the decision doctor has to take to get the cure of the disease of the patient. Therefore, patient. Now we are considering first step. Consider a patient. He will have cancer or not. These are the two possibilities, cancer or not, which leads to two possible results given in the question, namely recovering or death. Therefore, patient may have disease, may not have disease, operation can be performed or operation not performed, then what is the chance of his recovery or death? Possible results. Therefore, read the first line. There are 40%, first line says that 40% chance that a patient admitted to the hospital is suffering from cancer. First item is suffering from cancer. You can write cancer. Patient may have cancer. Point 4. Patient may have cancer. Point 4. From here you have point 6. No cancer. No cancer. No cancer. It is point 6. Then second line says that a doctor has to decide whether a serious operation should be performed or not. Operation to be performed or not. No operation to be performed or not. Therefore, here you have cancer, you have performing operation. Perform operation. Then you have no operation. No operation. Performing operation, no operation. Second line says that decide whether a serious operation should be performed or not. Third line says that if the patient is suffering from cancer, not suffering. If the patient is suffering from cancer and the serious operation is performed, the chance that he will recover is 0.7. Recovery is 70%. Recovery is 0.7. Suffering from cancer, operation performed, therefore recovery is 0.7. And the other option is, here no operation, therefore recovery is 0.7, therefore next outcome will be die. Recovering, and otherwise recovering or die, 0.3. Therefore, cancer is there, performed, recovery 0.7, otherwise die. Then, cancer, no operation performed, recover, die. Here you can see cancer is there, no operation performed, recovery is, you can see the third line says that, and the serious operation is performed is 70%, otherwise it is 35%. No operation, recovery is point, no, he will recover 70, otherwise, that is no operation means, recovery is, no operation means, recovery is 0.3, is equal to 0.35, therefore dying will be 0.65.
recovery is point, here it is 0.7, here is dying is 0.3, cancer, no operation, recovery 0.35 given, recovery, cancer, no operation, therefore recovery is 0.35 and die will be 0.65. Then fourth line. On the other hand, if the patient is not suffering from disease, not suffering from disease, and the operation is performed, operation, no operation. Therefore, no cancer, operations performed, serious operation performed, chance that he will recover is 0.2. Therefore, die is 0.8. No cancer, operation done, recovery 0.2, therefore dying is 0.8. The chance that he will recover is 0.2, otherwise it is 100. No operation, 100%, he can recover, 100% he can recover or he can die. Recover 100%, 100% equal to 1, 100% equal to 1 or die will be 0. No cancer, operation 0.2, balance 0.8, no cancer, no operation, recovery 100% automatically and probability equal to die will be equal to 0. Therefore, clubbing all these, you can see that here, 0.4, patient is having cancer or not having, suffering from cancer. If the patient is suffering from cancer, 0.4, operation performed, recovery 0.7. Cancer is there, operation performed, recovery is, this will be 0.7 into 0.4 equal to 0.28, first condition, 0.4 into 0.7. Here you have suffering from cancer, operation performed, unluckily die equal to 0.4 into 0.3 equal to 0.12. Then, 0.2, suffering from disease, no operation, recovery 0.35. Therefore, this will be suffering from cancer, no operation, recovery is 0.4 into 0.35 equal to 14%. Similarly, recovery 0.65. Therefore, this will be 0.4 into 65, 0.26. Again, here it is, same way you can calculate, 0.6 into 0.2, 0.12. Here it is, 0.48, 0.8 into 0.6, 0.48. And here it is 0.6 into 0.1, 0.6 into 1 equal to 0.6, and here it is 0, here it is 0, 0.6 into 0, here 0. Therefore, here we have, you can have probability 1 equal to the patient probability that
You can write P1 equal to probability that the patient shall recover, probability that the patient shall recover after operation, suffering from and after operation. Recovery 0.28 and recovery 0.12. Point recovery 1 cancer performed, recovery 0.28. No cancer goes on, recovery 0.2 equal to, therefore P1 equal to probability that patient shall recover after operation will be equal to 0.28 plus 0.12 equal to 0.4. 0.14. Then P2, probability that the patient will recover without operation. Probability that the patient will recover without any operation equal to 0.14 and 0.6 and 0.6. 0.14 plus 0.6 equal to 0.74. Here we observe second probability P2 is greater than first probability P1. Therefore, we conclude the doctor should not take a decision for operation of the patient should not take a decision that operation should be performed should not take a decision that operation should be performed. This is about decision tree. An example I'll go given. Normally they will ask you only define decision tree. Therefore you can have this example if you remember that, or you can have notes, you can have decision, you have activities, you can have activities or strategy we have. Strategies we have. Decision tree. Okay. Decision tree we have done. Now we go for another chapter. Namely, Game theory. We go for game theory. Game theory. Can think of game theory. Normally game theory, you can remember, game theory means there is a game between two people or more than two people. Game theory, between two people minimum, or a game can be played between two people or more than two people. For example, you can have a single shuttle, or you can have two person playing, or you can have football, or you can have a cricket. There you have minimum two, greater than two. That game theory during May 19 MBA and December 19 MBA, they have included under compulsory question. they have included under compulsory question 20 marks. Therefore, game theory is slightly important. Game theory is slightly important. Simple, but you have some 4 or 5 types of problems which you can solve easily. Game theory important, comes under compulsory question of 20 marks and simple question, provided you remember some tricks under that. Then you can write, game theory deals with mathematical analysis of competitive problems. Competitive problems. Competitive problems. It is a decision tree. It is a decision theory applicable to competitive situations where there are 2 or more opposing parties with their conflicting interests, with their conflicting interests. In such situations, the action of one depends upon the one taken by the opponent. A competitive situation is called a game. Game theory does not explain how a game should be played. It describes only the procedure and the principles involved by which plays should be selected. Plays should be selected. Plays should be selected. Then, characteristics of games. Minimum two persons. Two person game. If number of persons is more than 2, it is called n person game. Number of people, n person game. Point 2, each player has finite number of courses of action. Number of courses of action, underline courses of action, or we say strategies, courses of action, strategies or alternatives available. For example, in a tournament of football, you might have heard alternatives of playing 4-2-4 system. 4-2-4 system, or you have 4-4-2 system, or 3-3-4 system. 4-2-4 system, 4-4-2 system, 3-3-4 system, and these all comes under different alternatives chosen by the competitors. Every player has, or every team has, several choices at his liberty. The next one, rules governing the choices are specified and known to all members of the team. The choices are to be made simultaneously so that no player knows his opponent's choice. A playoff game results when each of the players chooses one of his courses of action. Then every game results in, underline, every game results in an outcome, win or loss or a draw. These results are termed as payoffs. Are called payoffs. Payoffs. Then you can have two words are there, act or called strategy, are called strategy, which are explained as follows. That strategy means the total pattern of choices employed by any player. It may be defined as complete set of plans, especially specifying the player will do under every possible future contingency occurring during play of the game. The course of action within bracket act closes that the decision maker takes is called an act or strategy. Decision problems have at least two possible acts available. The results of any action on the part of a decision maker depend on certain factors which are often beyond his control. The number of factors influencing the decision maker may be finite or infinite. These factors are named as states of nature, or we say event states. states of nature, or second one was act or strategy, we say strategy, act or strategy. Then if a player plays only one course of action, plays only one course of action, all the time he is said to be adopting a pure strategy, P-U-R-E, pure strategy. If a player plays each courses of action a certain part of the time within bracket in fixed proportion bracket closes, he is said to be using mixed strategy. Mixed strategy is a selection among pure strategies with some fixed probabilities. Now we have another term which is called the payoff. P-A-Y-O-F-F. Payoff means it is the outcome of playing a game. It can be either monetary value, it can be allotted with monetary value. A payoff matrix is a table showing amounts received by the player, named at the left hand side, underline, amount received by a player named at the left hand side of the table after all possible plays of the game. Payment is made by the player named at the top of the table. Top of the table. And the, for example, payoff table will be as follows. Payoff table. Here you can write player A. Here you can write player B. You can have a matrix table, okay, you can have A11, A12, A21, A22. For example, A11 equal to 3, equal to 4, equal to 6, equal to 7. Monetary value, you are assigned monetary value. Then player 1, player 2. This is a matrix. A11, A12, A13, A11, A12, A21, A22. And you can have monetary value 3, 4. Monetary value given. Namely,
3, 4, 6, 7. Monetary value
adopted.
Then here you can write player here on the left side. Top right. Player A, player B. Here, A11, that is this number, is the amount received by player A. A11 is the amount received by player A if he chooses strategy number one. A11 is the amount received by the player A if he chooses strategy one or act one and player B chooses his first strategy. I'll repeat. Left side is received by player A. Player B, top right, the amount given by B to A. I'll repeat. A11 is the amount received by player A. If he chooses strategy 1 and B adopts strategy 1. Here. Strategy 1. That is this way. Strategy 1. Here A11 denotes received amount by player A. And this also shows the amount given by the player B, to A. This also mentions, for example, amount 3 equal to A11. Denotes player A gets 3 rupees when he opts OPTS, when he opts strategy 1 and player B adopts strategy 1. A receives 3 rupees if he adopts strategy 1 and B also adopts strategy 1. Here rupees 3 is the received amount by A, and rupees 3 is the amount given by B, for the player A. 3 is the gain. And 3 is the lost amount for B. A is the gainer and B is the loser of 3 rupees. Similarly,
If player A adopts, player A adopts strategy 2, if the player A adopts strategy 2 and player B adopts strategy 1, player adopts 2, player A adopts 2 second strategy and player B adopts strategy 1 represents A21. Similarly, A12 means player A adopts strategy 1 and player B adopts strategy 2. A1 first strategy, B strategy 2. Similarly, for example, A22 means player A adopts second strategy and B adopts second strategy down. Second strategy. Here the amount 7 shown, rupees 7 is the gain for A. And it is a loss for B. Means left side it is a gain and top right is the loser. Gain of one player equals loss of the other. Gain of one player equal to loss of the other. In a non-zero sum game, the sum of the payoffs from any play of the game is not zero. It may be either positive or negative. Then I'll be explaining you how to prepare a payoff. That is a lengthy procedure, how to prepare a payoff table. That we will study later, payoff table. Before that, I gave you explanation for payoff. Gain and loser. B is the loser and A is the gainer, depending upon the strategy adopted by A as well as B. Now, next one, value of the game. It is the average payoff per play of the game. Average payoff per play of the game over an extended period of time. Value of the game. Then next point, normally they are asking what is meant by saddle point. For these 2 years, that is May 19 and December 19, for these two exams they have asked you define saddle point. Then saddle point means an equilibrium point in a pay of matrix, in a pray of matrix, pay of equilibrium point, in a pay of matrix, which is the smallest value, which is the smallest value, underline smallest value, in its row, smallest value in its row, and largest value in its column, where smallest value in its row, largest value in its column, where maximum of row is considered, where maximum of row is considered, maximum row is considered, and which coincides with, and which coincides with minimum of, coincides with minimum of column, which coincides with, coincides with minimum of column. It's equilibrium equilibrium point, where smallest value in its row, where maximum of row is considered, largest value in its column, where minimum of column is considered, where minimum of column is considered. Or in short, or in short, we consider the equilibrium point as, the equilibrium point as, equilibrium as, saddle point is defined as minimum of maximum of row equal to minimum of maximum of row equal to maximum of minimum, minimum column, minimum of maximum of row equal to, this is your saddle point, maximum of minimum column, or we say, or here we say maxi mini of row equal to mini max of column. Mini max of column. Saddle point is different as equilibrium point, wherein minimum of maximum of row. You find maximum value of the row. There will be two or three or four rows. You find initially maximum of the rows, and from there choose minimum. Find maximum of all rows and choose the minimum value. If it is equal to, you choose minimum of the column or minimum of all columns and take maximum of that. Minimum of columns and maximum out of the column. Or we say maxi mini, that is consider maximum, choose minimum of row. Consider maximum of row and choose minimum of row. Here it is, you choose minimum of column and take maxi. Therefore, saddle point equal to maxi mini, maxi mini equal to mini max, means find initially find minimum,
minimum and take maximum. Here you take off row. Here you take maximum of column and take minimum out of that, minimum out of value. So always remember maxi minimum is minimum you choose, out of that maximum. Maximum of minimum of row, or minimum of maximum of row. Maximum find find minimum of row and take maximum. Minimum of row and take maximum. Maxi mini means minimum of row and take maximum. Here it is maximum of column, you take minimum out of that. Maxi mini should be equal to mini max. Therefore, your point is you choose minimum always, first number one, then you take the maximum. This is the first step. Second is this. Here you have first step, then you go for two. Never do get confused. Maxi mini and mini max. Maxi mini means minimum initially, then maximum. They are reverse. Subtle point is maxi mini, find maximum, then minimum. Maxi mini, mini max. Maxi mini means find minimum and out of that maximum. And the saddle point is often written as V. Saddle point is written as V. Then we will do one or two problems under this. One, type one. Solve the following game problem. Find the saddle point or solve the game. Normally they will say solve the game. Player A, player B, strategy 1, strategy 2, or the player B. Solve the following game. 3. Here also 3. Two strategy here, here it is three strategy. Player has only two strategy, player B has three strategy. That is normally we say two rows and three columns. 2, -1, 3, 4, 5, 6. Step number one, as you know, 2 is the gain by A and this is the loss for A. Similarly, -1 is the gain for A and positive 1 will be gain for B. Similarly, 5 means gain for A, loss for B. Gain for A, loss for B. Solve the following game. This is, you can write, this is 2 by 3 matrix.
the saddle point is found out as follows. Saddle point is found out as follows. Initially we consider, here you have maxi, mini, mini, max. Here it is row, here it is column. Therefore, find minimum of rows, minimum of rows. First row, minimum, minus 1. Second row, 4, minimum of row 1, row 2, minimum of that. Out of this, maximum of row, 4, out of this, maximum. Initially you find minimum of row, 2 minus 1, 3, minus 1, 4, 5, 6, 4. Out of that you find 4. Therefore you can write maxi, mini equal to 4, condition 1. Maxi, mini equal to condition 1. Condition 1. Then come back to this column wise. Column means mini max. Therefore you write maximum of columns. First column 4 5 6 4 5 6, maximum of columns. First column, second column, this is first column, maximum, second column. And from this, you chose minimum. Minimum of max of columns. Find the minimum. Minimum is 4. Minimum is 4. Therefore, you can write mini max equal to 4. Step number 2. See step number 1. Here we observe maxi, mini equal to mini max. Maxi, mini equal to mini max equal to 4. Therefore, saddle point equal to 4. Therefore, saddle point equal to 4. Or value of the game equal to 4. Value of the game equal to 4. Which means value of the game equal to 4, which means optimum strategy is, normally we say you underline 4 in the matrix given. Matrix given was 2 minus 1, 3, 4, 5, 6. Therefore, this is the value of the game or saddle point is 4. Underline that. And this falls here. 4 is here. Means A should play. Strategy number 2 and B should play strategy number 1. We say 2-1. Then another question, one more. Solve the following game. You can write left side player.
player A. You can write player B. It is 3-2. You have 3-2. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 2, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. 3, 2, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, 5. Now, solution is, find maximini. Therefore, you find minimum of rows. Minimum of rows, row 1. Minimum 2, row 2, minimum minus 3, row 3, row 3, minus 5, minus 5, and maximum 2, minus 3, minus 5, and from this maximum equal to 2, condition 1. Maximum is 2, condition 1. Then come back to column 1 you find the maximum, column 1 maximum 3, column 2 maximum 2, find minimum of maximum column, minimum of maximum column 2, condition 2, condition 2. Therefore, here we observe maximini equal to 2 and minimax equal to 2, minimax equal to 2. Therefore, saddle point equal to value equal to 2. Value equal to 2, and that falls under player A first strategy and player B 2. Player A first strategy, player B strategy 2. Or therefore, value the game equal to 2, equal to 1, 2. Means A should play first strategy and B should play second strategy. A should play first strategy and B should play second strategy. And the value of the game is equal to 2. Value of the game equal to 2. Okay, this is for today. We will have another class under game theory.